Question number 12. Now, in this one, we're given some information about theta, but we don't need to find theta. We're finding the function value, the cosecant of theta and the tangent of theta. Remember, those are going to be some values. So the information we have is that we are in the second quadrant. Cosine theta is equal to -2/3, which is good because a cosine in the second quadrant needs to be negative. So we're over here in quadrant 2. And remembering cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse. So the fraction we're given tells us that this is -2, the distance here, right? It's a distance of 2, but we'll mark it as -2 because that's where we are. Over here is the hypotenuse we're given as 3. So if we need anything, and again, this is, well, actually, the angle comes from 0 up to here. That's really theta. But we can use the reference angle, right? Here's our reference angle. And so this is going to be an opposite side. So if we need that opposite side, we're going to, we're thinking ahead. Cosecant is related to sine, which needs the opposite. Tangent is opposite over adjacent. So yeah, we need this opposite side. And remember, we could think of that as being the B side. So whenever we have the hypotenuse, what we do is we subtract B is equal to C squared minus A squared, the square root. So that's kind of the quick one, because right, A squared plus B squared equals C squared. Well, C squared is a hypotenuse. This is our C. This would be our A, and that would be our B. And so when you solve over, the A comes over. That's why it's subtraction here. And then that gives us B squared, but we want B, so we got to take the square root. So if you kind of remember this, that's helpful. If not, go through the algebra steps to get there. So we're going to take the square root of 3 squared minus, I'm going to put it in as -2 squared, because that's what we would, so that's 9 minus 4 square root, which is square root of 5. So that's the opposite side. And that's all we really need. So let's go ahead and go cosecant. And remember that that is 1 over sine. And now what is sine? It's opposite over hypotenuse. So that's 1 over opposite hype. Okay, put those there. Opposite is square root of 5. Hypotenuse is 3. Remember, we're going to get the reciprocal 3 over square root of 5. And if you missed out on the other ones, that's 1 divided by square root of 5 over 3. Remember, you invert and multiply 1 times 3 over square root of 5, which gets us to that answer. Okay, so we'll put that in, fraction 3 and square root of 5. So there are some sort of hints in here of what Alex is looking for when they give you the tools. They don't give you all the tools if you don't need it. They don't give us a pi. We don't really worry about whether we're radians or degrees at this point, because we're actually not finding the angle. The last one should be fairly straightforward. Tangent theta is opposite over adjacent, and remember, we're in the second quadrant, so it should be negative, and we're going to follow our triangle here. Opposite is square root of 5, adjacent is -2, so that gives us negative square root of 5 over 2. And we could come over here, we'll put our negative fraction, square root, 5, and 2. And that's going to be our answer for number 12.